Thank you for watching videos by Jeff Sibelius and LandAndAirPhotos.com. In my recent episode of Drone News, I said that DJI was planning to release the Mavic Mini 2. Well, it happened. DJI released the Mini 2 drone today. The Mini 2 looks the same as the Mini, except for some slight branding differences and colored tips on the props. It still weighs below 249 grams, and it's still a very irresponsible shade of gray. The changes to the Mini 2 are basically all on the inside. One big change is that the camera shoots up to 4K at 30 frames per second, an improvement over the Mini's 2.7K max. The bitrate has also been improved to 100 megabits per second over the Mini's 40 megabits per second. Another big enhancement is that the Mini 2 has OcuSync 2.0, which delivers a maximum range of up to 10 kilometers. I really love OcuSync on my Mavic Air 2, so this really is a big improvement to me. The last major change for the Mini 2 is that it uses the new transmitter design first used with the Mavic Air 2. People who want the Mini for its portability may not like this. The new transmitter is bigger than the old one. I like the new transmitter, so I'm good with this change. The other improvements are basically incremental. The Mini 2 is supposed to handle winds from 8.5 to 10.5 meters per second. The Mini was rated for 8. I still believe the Mini 2 will have problems flying in wind. Changing the maximum pitch angle on the drone won't help it hold its position in a stiff crosswind, but we will see. The Mini 2 is rated for flight times up to 31 minutes, which is 1 minute more than the Mavic Mini. The Mini 2 is also rated to be able to launch at up to 4,000 meters altitude, an improvement over 3,000 meters for the Mini. I think it was on Potato Jet's review of the Mini where he had trouble keeping the Mini flying at higher altitudes, so this may be of some value to some of you. The Mini 2 is more expensive than the Mini, as you can see on screen. As with the Mavic Mini, the Mini 2 Flymore combo is probably worth the extra price if you can afford it. Those extra batteries and charging hub add a lot of value. I wonder if the Mini 2 will support the DJI smart controller. That would be a good selling point for the Mini 2. Or, if it doesn't support the smart controller, that would be a big reason to buy the Air 2 instead. So, what do you think of the Mini 2? Is this a good upgrade for the Mini? Will you be buying one? Post your thoughts in the comments below. I really want to know what you think. Here's what I think about the new drone. The Mini 2 is a decent upgrade to the Mavic Mini. Higher video resolution and the OcuSync transmission system are nice benefits. My biggest problem with the first Mavic Mini was how it handles wind, and I'm skeptical that the Mini 2 will do much to improve on that. Also, the Mini 2 is more expensive, so it's closer in price to the Mavic Air 2. Will the reduced savings make the Air 2 a better value? I've got the Mini 2 on order, so I'll be testing how it handles wind, what kind of value it offers, and a lot more in an upcoming non-fanboy review. Be sure to subscribe so you know when that's published. Are you looking to buy the Mavic Mini 2, the Mavic Air 2, or the Mavic Mini? Use the links in the description below and order direct from DJI. Support this channel with affiliate link purchases so I can keep making videos for you. I will be doing more videos on the Mini 2, so be sure to subscribe so you know when they're released. On screen, you'll find links to more videos on the Mavic Mini, Mavic Air 2, and the Mini 2. Before you go, please take a moment to subscribe and leave a comment. Tell me what you think of the Mini 2. Thanks for watching.